when you walk into a room full of strangers, most of the time, uncomfortable, right? But why do we feel that way? We obviously feel nervous when we speak to strangers, but there are so many other thoughts that goes into our mind, such as, what if I do or say something embarrassing? What if they don't like me? Maybe I'm boring for them. So a lot of times, we find it easier to avoid such situations. But you and I know that conversation plays an important part in our life. Talking with someone else stimulates us. It offers us new ideas. It builds our confidence. It improves our network. And most importantly, conversation plays a significant part in our success in life. So, benefits are huge. But then the question is, how do we converse with others at ease? Like everything else, for skillful conversation, it needs preparation. It's important to understand different levels of communication that everyone uses. For example, level one of communication can be small talk. You can talk about the weather, you can talk about the immediate surrounding, you can even give a compliment. Level two of communication can be disclosure. At this stage, you can give, you know, you can disclose information that's not very personal. It can be your profession, it can be your interest, it can be your hobbies. Level three of communication is sharing viewpoints and opinions. You can share viewpoints about politics. You can have your viewpoints about a mutual acquaintance. And level four of communication is about sharing personal feelings. So, for example, let's say you can talk about an ongoing problem with your boss and your concern about the future relationship between you and your boss. A successful conversation starts at the first level, then it moves on to the second, then to the third, and it ends at the fourth level. Jumping from level one to level four, as you can imagine, can lead to an awkward conversation. So the recommendation is to try and avoid that. There are a few other ingredients for a successful conversation which I'll very quickly mention. Number one, listening. Better listening, as you all know, almost always lead to a conversation which will flow better and smoother. Level number two is ask open-ended questions. If you ask closed questions, most likely you'll get answers which are either yes or a no. Asking open-ended questions will give the opportunity for a more detailed response. And number three, don't overshare. People feel uncomfortable when they hear a stranger's deepest secret. So again, recommendation is to try and avoid the temptation to overshare. Now I'm going to do a brief role play where it's a conversation between me and someone, let's say, who is a stranger I have met for the first time. And to do that, I would like to invite Gary onto the stage. Please give a very warm welcome to Gary. So the situation is this. I'm at a marketing conference. And as it happens in conferences, people talk to people that they have never met before. I see Gary at the coffee break. I walk up to him and I introduce myself. Good morning, I'm Hira.
Hi, Hira.
And I'm here.
How are you doing?
Yeah, very well, thank you. I'm here in the conference as a delegate. Very pleased to meet you.
Okay. I'm a delegate also. Have you just come in, or where did you fly in from?
I pretty much live here, so I'm kind of, you know, it's an hour drive, so it wasn't bad at all. So what brings you here today? Is it professional development, personal training?
I'm here to learn about what my competitors are doing and just see what they're strategies are. So I'm here really in a stealth mode, and it's really interesting what some of them are doing, the way they're advancing and strategies are doing.
Really interesting. I mean, I think this conference is an interesting one for professionals like us, because this provides so much of practical insights, which you don't see many conferences doing these days. So I'm really looking forward to the sessions. By the way, I really like your watch. I think it's the shape. I have got a bit of a passion for watch, and I was reading an article the other day, and it does say that, you know, the black and the gold, you know, this is all coming back on trend. Okay. So maybe your watch can be trendy.
I wouldn't be known as the trendiest guy in the world, but
your watch is.
My watch is, okay, thanks. Actually, I was on business in Istanbul, and the Turkish lira at the time was in the toilet, and thought, not a bad time to buy a good watch, so. Next time you're in Turkey and the Turkish lira is down.
Don't know when that's going to be. Today's conference. So between the agenda and the speakers, which bit is more interesting to you?
The speakers, one or two of the speakers are quite a level of interest. And there are two companies that I'm partnering with on a big project as well. And so meeting them later this evening is actually going to be a bigger part of the deal in terms of the value from the conference for me.
Okay.
Are you presenting anything, or are you here just observe? Or?
No, clearly this is a learning opportunity for me.
Yeah.
But like you said, I'm very much looking forward to the speakers, because I think it's a great lineup of speakers. And especially, you know, the session about marketing and sales collaboration.
Okay.
I really want to know what they have to say about it. So it should be a good one.
Have you a background in marketing and sales collaboration?
Yeah, I mean, I do a lot of work between sales and marketing, and mm-hmm. how companies can collaborate to, you know, make it more sustainable, you know, and, you know, produce better results. So yeah, that's obviously my professional interest as well. So yeah. So apart from conferences, do you do anything else to keep yourself up to date?
Oh, I'm not at conferences, I'm working.
You're working.
Yeah,
so this is like a nice break.
It's a bit of a break, a bit of time for a bit of strategic thinking as opposed to operational focus.
Sure.
So I'm interested in what you say, though, because I see people often developing products together, investing together. I haven't seen many doing joint marketing, unless it's maybe somebody making something and working with somebody who's selling their product.
Mm-hmm.
So what kind of collaborations do you see in sales and marketing?
Well, I think in organizations, I do see that they work as silos. I think first thing that needs to be done is that we work together, because marketing does the preliminary work for sales. And once that's developed, it's the sales job to really take it to the market. So I think rather than working in silos, they all have to be part of one team. Now, I was going to say, now that we don't have enough time, we have got our lunch break, which is for 2 hours. If you're not doing very much at all, then maybe we can catch up and speak a little bit more on this topic. Yeah.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much. It's a great pleasure meeting you. And
advice.
I'll see you during the next break. Thank
Take
you.
Back to hear it.
No, that's fine. So this was like an impromptu conversation we had. Nothing was planned. In the manual, I have been asked that, you know, what Gary thinks, how we could improve the conversation. Gary, did you have to say anything? If at all we had to improve, if there was anything?
Just based on our conversation there, well, seeing as how I don't know what the conference was really. You gave me a bit of a hint with sales and marketing, so I kind of went on that.
Sure, yeah.
But yeah. You could very easily, the questions are quite open, the flow of that was pretty good, and I never felt uncomfortable that I was kind of moving too fast, so yeah, it was fine.
Thank you so much, Gary. A huge round of applause for Gary. professional background and then a little bit of interest about watches. And also we discussed a bit of viewpoints. And at the end, as I thought the conversation was going smoothly, so I checked if he can spare a little bit more time later on. So now I would like to invite you all to ask me any questions, because that's a part also of the manual. So I probably have got a few minutes, so any questions you would have?
I've got one. How do you tackle, so in the context of Jerry, clearly he was quite open to have a conversation. How do you deal with people that are closed, right? So you ask an open question, but they sort of come back to you with a kind of a one-line response.
Yeah.
How do you kind of open them up?
Sure, yeah, that's, I think, is always a difficult question. And like we all know, we kind of get a signal that this person either doesn't want to talk, or otherwise there isn't a common interest. But then in places like conference, you still want to strike a conversation. So like I said, one of the points is ask open questions, rather than asking, are you here as a delegate? If you ask, so what brings you here? So hopefully you can only expect that rather than one-liner, he or she will have a little bit more to talk about. So I suggest probably open questions are always a safe bet. And also, like they say in every conversation, initially try to understand, is there a common interest? If there is absolutely nothing, then probably it's the wrong place to be. So I hope that answers your question. Thank you. Any more questions?
How would you handle questions from someone that you've just met, where they immediately jump into level 3 or your level 4, which is more personal than you might want to be with somebody whom you've just met?
So are you saying how somebody moved from first to the level 4? How do you deal with that? Is that what you're asking?
Yes.
Well, do you know, not everybody quite knows, what the structure should be. And I think you always get people, who do not follow the structure. I don't necessarily think it's always difficult. I don't know if I have the answer to that. As my personality, I don't have too much of a problem dealing with that, because if you don't want to get involved in too much of personal stuff, you don't have to really respond too much. Just listen and not really, take it further, probably. But I probably wouldn't have a very good answer for that, because I haven't faced that very much, or maybe because my personality, it's not something offensive for me, so I'll probably carry on with what the other person wants to share. But I don't know if exactly what you were asking. But my time is over anyway, so I think I'll have to hand it over to our toastmaster. But anyway, thank you.
Thank you, Hera.